that I'm here back again after 5 years in West Plains. I think some of you have seen 5 years back, and most of you are new. And I'm so happy that I'm here with my sister and my parents. I know that God has a plan for each one of us. And I also know that this particular meeting today is by God's divine plan. If that is so, all of us are going to be touched and blessed. Mm-hmm. We are not going to go back the same way as we have come. How many of you believe that? Mm-hmm. That we are going to receive a special blessing, and God is going to touch us. God is going to heal us. God is going to rejuvenate us. And God is going to make something new in our life. Hallelujah. And this weekend is going to be a weekend of revival, a weekend of blessing, where supernatural things will happen in your life. Not natural, not the ordinary, not what you see every Saturday, Sunday, but something special, something divine. Hallelujah. Because when we are gathered together in God's name, He is there. So if God is here with us, He's going to touch each one of us. He is going to bless. So we need to be prepared and be ready to receive what God has for each one of us. I'm so excited. I don't know whether you are, but I'm excited. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because I know God works. Amen. I know God answers prayers. Amen. I know He's mighty. And I know He's a creator. In the beginning, God created everything from nothing. Hallelujah. Yes. Praise Hallelujah. The Lord. Yes. Please come. He created everything from nothing. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Yes. How are you?
Good to see you again. Good to see you.
In the beginning, God created everything from nothing. Everything from nothing. How did He create? By His word. So God can create something from our nothingness by His word. How many of you realize that God can create something today, tonight, in our nothingness by His word? Amen. He created everything from nothing. All that we see in our life, all that we see around, the plants, the birds, the animals, everything God created from nothing. And He is going to create something from our vacuum, our nothing.
Amen.
Some of us feel nothing sometimes. Not good. Not really fit. But God is going to do that. Create everything from nothing. How did He do that? In the beginning, God created everything from nothing by His word. It says the darkness was all over, but the Spirit of God was hovering over the darkness. If you allow the Spirit of God to remain in your life, the nothingness will automatically change. When the angel appeared to Mary, the virgin, and said, you are going to conceive a child by the Spirit. How will it happen? Mary asked the question, I'm a virgin. The angel said, the Spirit, the power of God will over you. And your nothingness, your barrenness is going to change. And you're going to conceive a baby. How many of you are excited to conceive something new? Hallelujah. You think the age is over, the time is over. Abraham thought so. Sarah thought so. In fact, Isaac's meaning is laughter. When the angel promised Sarah that she's going to have a baby, she laughed. She said, everything is over. I'm just trying to pass my time. No, you're not just passing time. Hallelujah. God has a wonderful plan for you, which you have never done before. Something new, something unique. Amen. And that's what we are going to hear today. Please make sure that you come for all these meetings on the weekend and attend. Bring your friends, and there are going to be a lot of us speaking to you, and you're going to be healed, you're going to be touched, and West Plains is going to be on fire.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Your hearts is going to be on fire.
Amen.
The fire of God is going to fall on each one of us.
Amen.
All you need to do is allow yourself to be under the presence of God.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit. Remain under the presence of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Allow the Holy Spirit to remain on you. And new things are going to happen. I can already feel it. I don't know whether you are feeling it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. As I go forward with this Bible study, I would request all of you, those who have your Bibles, please take your Bibles, and if you have a pen and paper, feel free, you don't mind. But if you have a tongue and hands clapping between, say praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This is to worship God. We are here to worship God. Hallelujah. So we will start with our message today. 1 John chapter 1, verse 1, 2, 3. 1 John's, John's epistles, 1 John chapter 1, and somebody can read that aloud for me if you have taken, verse 1, 2, and 3. That's where we begin. We are going to have a long Bible study. I was told that I can take 1 to 2 hours, the whole night is for me.
Amen.
No, don't worry. Praise God. We will stop in time. So we will begin with this verse, 1 John chapter 1, and 1, 2, and 3. That's where we're going to begin. So anybody who has taken, just read it loud for us so that we start our study right away. All of us are ready? Shall we start reading? Okay, somebody can start that for me loudly.
That which was from the beginning.
That which was from the beginning.
Which we have heard.
Which we have heard.
Which we have seen.
Which we have seen.
Which we have looked upon.
Looked upon.
And our hands have handled.
And our hands have handled. This is what I'm going to speak today. Something that was from the beginning. Something that was from the beginning. Which we have heard. Which we have heard. Which we have looked upon or seen. And which we have handled with our hand. These are three experiences. Like if I'm standing far away and I'm shouting, you may not see me, but you can still hear me. Okay? So first you start hearing the word of God. Where you stand away from God, but you are able to hear him, not see him.
That's right.
That's right. That's where we all began. Where we were far away and you hearing what we have heard, something that was from the beginning. That is God. That's the word of God.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. We heard it.
Amen.
And once you hear the word, it's like a magnet. It will attract you. Woo, like this. You can't stay where you are. You want to go and hear more. You want to hear more. And then you come closer. Then you come to the next stage of your spiritual life where you see. How many of you have started seeing the word? Hearing the word is different. All of us have that capacity. But the next experience is seeing the word of God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. John's Gospel chapter 1 is very clear that it says, word became flesh and lived among us. That is Jesus. So Jesus is God's word becoming flesh and living among us. So what we have seen, then what happened? What we have heard, then what we have seen, and then finally, what we have handled, touched. This is a close encounter. You can't handle sitting far away. You can hear and see, but if you want to touch and handle it, you have to get closer. So John had that experience of hearing the word, seeing the word, and what? What did we read? What we have, what was from the beginning? What we have? Seen, heard, and handled, touched. Oh, that is what we are going to do today. You've been hearing, and some of you have been seeing, but you have to touch. When you start handling the word of God, touching the word of God, when the word start touching you, your fears will go. Your worry will go. Your loneliness will go. Your inadequacies will go. Your weakness will go. Your tiredness will go. Everything will start freeing when the word start touching you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So it's a gradual experience of your life where you go from hearing to seeing to handling. Let's proceed what is written there. That is the word of life. This is the word of life and not death.
Amen.
What we hear outside and what we read outside is always death. And what we are hearing here right now is word of life.
Right.
Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life.
Right.
I was in a big interview, and my friend who was interviewing me asked me, Dr. Kovur, You are a neurosurgeon. You are a head of a department. You are a secular man. And you also preach. How could you say that Jesus is the only way? How could you say that Jesus is life? Is it fair? I smiled at him. I prayed immediately, God, give me an answer. And God gave me the answer. I told this friend of mine, I did not say, Jesus said. Hallelujah. None of us said that. Who said, I am the light of the world?
Jesus
said. Who said, I am the life and resurrection?
Jesus
said. Hallelujah. Who said, I am the way, the truth, and the life?
Jesus
said. We believe it. And we are going to experience it today. Hallelujah. This is the life. What did we say? What was this? The word of life. Word of
life.
Some people think having a protein shake in the morning will make you better. It will. Having lots of vitamin pills will give you energy. It will. But let me tell you, the very first day, the secret of my energy is Holy Spirit.
Amen.
How many of you believe that?
Amen.
Hallelujah. If that is a secret, tonight, this evening, you are going to be rejuvenated.
Amen.
In according to the Psalm 103, it says, your youth is going to be renewed like the eagles.
That's right.
That this evening meeting is to put back your clock by 10 years. Whatever age you have come in, you're going to go back 10 years back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because it is not my promise. It's the promise of the word of God.
Amen.
It says the youth can be renewed like the eagles. You have thought, oh, everything is over, fine, I'm tired now. What is it? Why am I existing? No. God is going to change and give you back your youth. You have to believe. You have to have faith. And you have to receive this word. Hallelujah. Let's go forward in our study. John chapter 1st John chapter 1. Again, what does it say?
One again?
Yeah, continue the, where we stopped.
Okay, for the life was manifested and we have
seen. The life was manifest in him and we have seen. This just shocked me. John is saying that the life was manifest in Jesus, which he did not see in Peter. We did not see in James. There was a life that was manifest in Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. What is this life? It was different from all the other people. We saw life manifest in him. Till then, the whole world did not see that life. This life was lost in the Garden of Eden.
Amen.
God said, when you eat the fruit, you will die. The sin took away that life from our body, from our life. We live, but we don't have that life, which is today's message. That life. God has brought you to have that special life, which is going to be the powerhouse of your life, which was manifest in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. When life comes, you automatically start praising.
Amen.
When you praise, the prison will break. Hallelujah. When you praise, your chains will fall. When you praise, you will start receiving healing. Hallelujah. No, then you're going to have a new system. When I say one hallelujah, I get two hallelujah free. Buy one, get one free. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We are worshippers. We are people who praise God. Why do we praise him? Because we have received so much from him.
Amen.
Because we have heard him. We have seen him. And tonight we are touching him.
Amen.
We are here to touch him.
Amen.
The word, that life, which was there in the beginning, which was manifest in Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I am excited.
Amen.
Some of you are going to be changed. You are not going to go back. Because your clock is going to turn back. Hallelujah, hallelujah. If this evening is going to be a life-changing experience, because God is going to touch every one of you. Everyone knows John chapter 1, verse 1 and 2. In the beginning, there was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. So this Word we study here is God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And as we sit and study the word, this word gets into our heart. Into our heart. And becomes life. And gets into our cells. And becomes a micronutrition. And gets into our brain. And the dementia goes. And the Alzheimer's goes. Hallelujah. Do you believe that the neurosurgeon speaking to you? That when you read the word of God, you are going to be changed. You keep saying, my memory is gone. I can't think anything. I can't understand anything. No! That's Satan speaking through you. Hallelujah. The devil trying to degenerate your life. Saying that everything is over. No, it's a new beginning.
Amen.
His mercies are new every morning.
Amen.
Do you believe that?
Amen.
There is no deep freezer in the kingdom of God. There is no refrigerator and microwave where you make for 1 week and then heat it up every day. His mercy is new every morning. Every morning. Have you experienced that mercy today? Something new which you have never experienced before in your whole life. I know some of you are sitting here and say, is there a mercy which I have never experienced before? Is there a word which I have never heard before? I have been in the church for 30 years. And here comes a young man speaking, something new is coming. Something new is going to hit you tonight.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
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 I believe that. I believe this weekend is a weekend of revival for Osaka.
Amen.
And for West Plain and for this church.
Amen.
We don't come here by accident. I have closed my hospital for 1 month, which no doctor does.
Wow.
To be here with you.
Amen.
To see that this place is on fire.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 In John chapter 11. No, I'll read one more verse in John 1 verse 4. We'll continue after that. John 1 verse 4. John's Gospel chapter 1 verse 4. In the beginning, that same thing. Verse 4.
And these things write we unto you, that your joy may be full.
No, that is 1 John. This is John 1 verse 4. John's Gospel chapter 1 verse 4. In him was the light, which was the... In him was the life, which
the
was,
life
the,
was the light of men.
Yeah. In God was the life, which was the light of men. There is a connection between the light and life that was in Jesus. In the last day, Revelation says that he is the light of the New Jerusalem. The Lamb of God is going to be the light of the New Jerusalem. What we see, this natural light, is nothing compared to the light that was in God, in Jesus. If you want to know that more about that, you must go and read Revelation chapter 1, where the same John saw Jesus in the island of Patmos and fell down dead because he has never seen this Jesus before. Before he saw the human being as Jesus. Now he sees the power of God. Now, John chapter 11, verse 25. John's Gospel chapter 11, verse 25. Where Jesus says, I am the resurrection and I am the life. I am the life and the resurrection. Jesus is the life and resurrection. So when you have Christ, you have life in your life, in yourself. So when we lack life, what is what we need to have? Christ! When you think in the morning, oh, one more day. Terrible. I had enough. Or when you go to bed at night and say, oh, one more night, I'm so tired. What do you need at that point?
Jesus.
Because he is life. Jesus very clearly says, I am the life and resurrection. John chapter 11 verse 25. He says, I am the life and resurrection. John chapter 14 verse 6, he says, I am the truth and the life. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Are we together on the same page?
No.
No. Okay, so I take time. I want you to be with me on the same page. John 14 verse 6 and John 11 verse 25 where Jesus says, I am the resurrection and life. So here we are talking about life. In medicine, actually, there is no clear definition of life and death. Nobody knows exactly when life begins, nor death. You're surprised. But there was a point of time when they put a cotton in front of the nostril and said, oh, he's finished. That was called the respiratory death. Then they put the hand on the pulse and said, no, it's not over. There's something more going on. And then they realized that this is a second part. That is called the cardiac death. Now we know there's something else, which is called the brain death. Even if the heart stops, even the breathing stops, they don't declare a person dead, they wait. I'm telling you, that's not death yet. Nobody knows when the life begins and when it ends. It's actually a transfer into the world, out to the world. We are export quality. What we are, what you see, this is only the body. There is a person inside.
Yes.
And that person doesn't get old. That is why some of us still feel we are only 16. But our leg doesn't work, our hand doesn't work, our mouth doesn't work, our ears doesn't work. But we are still the same. That inner man doesn't get old. Today we are talking about putting life into that inner man, that your outer body starts rejuvenating. That you start getting life in your whole self. Not your decaying, not your degenerating, but you are rejuvenating. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. See, when God created Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden, He kept free oxygen and water for us after so many years to have. What a great planner He was. To have a medical oxygen, you had to pay so much. But God kept it free of cost over the generation. He kept our body so much that we are preserved so well for so many years. He kept all our organs functioning so well. He knows the secret of our life because He is the manufacturer. He is the main man. He is the creator. I'll tell you a small story. There was a young automobile engineer driving through one of the highways of America. A lonely night. As he was driving, as he went, suddenly his car broke down. He tried all the stuff. Nobody. Those days there was no cell phone, there was no helpline, nothing. So he was desperate. He was a mobile engineer. He knew everything. Then he saw a flicker of light from far. There was somebody driving down. And they came. In those days we stopped if you see somebody's having problem. Now we don't stop. And he stopped and asked, son, what's happening? He's an old man. He said, my car is not working. So this guy looked at the car like this and smiled and then asked for the key, opened the bonnet, did something and got into the main steering and did something. Within 5 minutes, the car was working. So this young automobile engineer was so surprised. He said, I've been trying for 2-3 hours and it was not working. You managed it in 5 minutes. How did you do that? He smiled and said, my name is Ford. This is my car. Hallelujah. You've been struggling to start your car so many times. And the life is not working. The gear is not changing. The car is not going forward. I'm talking about your creator. My creator. Who is able to change the situation. Heal you completely. Because He created your kidney. He created your heart. He created your brain. He is able to give back everything, life back into our heart, into our body, into our being. That's what we need to receive tonight.
Amen.
Hallelujah. 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 Shall we go proceed a little forward? Now we are going to get in deeper into the Bible study. 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16. I will serve salad, I will serve milk, and I will serve in between some hard meat also. So those who have good denture can jab it in. 1 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16. 1:6.
Without controversy, great is the mystery of godliness.
Great is the mystery of godliness. In this world, presently, nobody wants godliness. Everybody wants worldliness. If you say you are a God-believing neurosurgeon, they'll think, oh no, he doesn't know. But if I say I'm an atheist and I'm a neurosurgeon, oh, he's a genius. If you look at the world is going in an entirely different direction. They are promoting things which are not existing according to the line of God. That's called worldliness. I will put it in a different way. I don't know whether you have understood this point now. Let me say it very simply. All that we see here are temporary. You get me?
Yeah.
All that we see are temporary, and all that is unseen are permanent. Eternal, that's right, eternal. All that is unseen is eternal. Since you use that word eternal, let me say, the Bible says, God put eternity in the heart of men. So only those people who has that eternity put in their mind will keep thinking about eternity. God has to put that eternity in your heart. God put eternity in the heart of men. Once you receive that revelation and receive eternity in your heart, you start thinking about the day-to-day mundane life.
Right.
If you are so engrossed with day-to-day life, you are far from eternity. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You are living a pagan life. You may be born again, you may be baptized, you may be a great saint of God, but you are only bothered about the day-to-day life. That means you have something is going away. See, the mystery of godliness is making us the bride, the church, unto Jesus, preparing us for his second coming.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
How I wish I could take a class on the second coming of Christ, which I was doing in our church for a couple of weeks together. I started with 15 signs, then I made it 25 signs. The last time I found 40 signs, and let me tell you, almost all of them are already fulfilled. And if all of them are fulfilled, we are at the brink of a great renewal.
Yes.
What is that? The second coming of Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Are we ready to receive him?
Amen.
Are we ready to meet him?
Yes. Yes.
When the trumpet sounds, angels are not coming down with batteries to charge mortal beings and transfer them into immortal beings and empower them to go up into heaven. No. It is the resurrected power that is in us today, the Holy Spirit that is in us today, which is going to transform our mortal bodies and take us up. And if you don't have that much of voltage now, you get what I'm speaking?
Yeah.
What we need tonight is a filling of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
A revival, that we are charged back so that when the trumpet calls, we go shak ladak in 1 second. Hallelujah. 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 I'm so excited because I know God is going to touch all of you. I know there is one candle of fire for each one of you, which is going to fall on each one of our head. That nobody is going to go empty handed.
Hallelujah.
The mystery of godliness. I want you to go back and dwell in the depth with the word to find out this mystery of godliness. What does it mean to be godly? To be godlike. That's what God wants. The life that was lost in the Garden of Eden, which was manifest in Jesus Christ, to be manifest in us. So that when we go to the operation theater, people see a different life. When we work, when we walk, when we talk, there is a different life that is manifest in us. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That is called the mystery of godliness.
Hallelujah.
1 John. We'll come back to 1 John again where we started. 1 John chapter 5 verse 20. John's Gospel, first epistle, chapter 5 verse 20.
And we know that the Son of God is come.
Yeah.
And he has given us an understanding that we may know him that is true, and we are in him that is true, even in his Son Jesus Christ. This is the true God and eternal life.
This is a true God and eternal life. This is a true God and eternal life. So that means there are false gods.
Yes.
Yes. Lot of people who are claiming to be false gods. I don't know how much in America, but in India there are many. Many Sai Babas, many Amritandam, a lot of people who claim themselves to be God. Human beings who claim themselves to be God. It is actually one of the oldest philosophy in India, Advaita, where we become gods. It is true in the word that ultimately God is going to transform us into his likeness, that we become the bride of Christ. But right now we are human beings.
Hallelujah.
And there's only one true God and one Savior, that's Jesus Christ. And eternal life is only through Him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That is very clear if you read verse 11 in the same chapter, chapter 5, verse 11, where we find that it is in His Son that there is life.
And this is the record that God has given to us, eternal life, and this life is in His Son.
In His Son. The life was manifest in Jesus.
Amen.
Which nobody saw before. The life is in His Son, Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And when you receive Jesus in your heart, you are receiving the life in your heart.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So your children will start seeing something which they have never seen before. Your grandchildren will start seeing. They will say, this grandma is different. Not by the fair and lively and the pawns and other cream that she puts on. Not by the makeup. That's good. But by the life that flows through her life, which is Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen.
And that life will keep changing you every day. I can challenge you. Once you start walking with Jesus,
Amen.
Your life will be renewed every day.
Hallelujah.
Enoch walked with God and he was no more. He was taken up. How many of you want to be taken up?
Amen.
You just walk with God.
Amen.
You try 2014, one day of walk with God will transform you more than anything else.
Amen.
More than attending 1 week of revival
meeting.
Just walk with God one day. Practice the presence of God one day in your life. You do it once a month, I'm telling you, it's going to be powerful. Once a week, I don't know whether others can walk with you. You will become so powerful. And if you do it every day, you will be seen no more. Hallelujah. God has brought you us together to give us the mystery of godliness, to teach us something beyond.
Amen.
Not what we have been practicing, but something what God wants you to be. Hallelujah. And that transformation is going to begin today. And when you go back, even tonight as you take rest in the bed, in your beds, I'm going to tell you this word is going to touch you.
Amen.
And continue to work in you.
Amen.
You know, aerobics and weightlifting has different experience. Aerobics is just exercising for the moment, and once you finish, it's over. But weightlifting, and there are certain other exercises, which gives you fat burning for 5 to 10 hours after that. And the word of God is even more powerful. You hear it now, it will have fat burning for another 2-3 days. It's not finished in 2 minutes.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It's going to continue to work in your life. And this weekend is a weekend of renewal.
Him that is of power to establish you according to my gospel and the preaching of Jesus Christ according to the revelation of the mystery which was kept secret since the world began.
So mystery of godliness was kept secret from the world began. And it was actually shown to us through Jesus Christ. Are you getting? All the prophets, all Moses, Abraham, everybody was looking forward to this generation. Right? This was kept as a secret.
Amen.
Now it's being revealed to us through Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Isn't that exciting? What Abraham was waiting for, what David was waiting for, what Moses was waiting for, is being made manifest to us. Hallelujah! The mystery. Let's go forward. Yes?
But now is made manifest, and by the scriptures of the prophets, according to the commandment of the everlasting God, made known to all nations for the obedience of faith.
Amen. Now is made known to obedience of faith, made known to the whole nations, all over the world. Before the second coming of Christ, the mystery of godliness has to be revealed to everyone. Hallelujah. And as you keep walking with God, every day you will learn something new.
Amen.
Which you have never learned before. You can't be satisfied with what you've known before. You have to learn something new. Because God is going to speak something new to you. Chapter 2, 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 10. Here it says, He abolished death and brought eternal life to us. He abolished death and brought eternal life to us. That was the greatest thing that Jesus did. when he died on the cross of Calvary. He took the power of death from our life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He conquered death. He abolished death and gave us eternal life.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Our life story is not going to end by the end of our life here.
Amen.
You think of Abraham Lincoln or you think of any political leader. They have a say in this world, Mahatma Gandhi or anyone. But you think of Peter. How many books are written about Peter? He didn't write much. How much is talk about Peter? How many children are named about Peter? Why that single fisherman? Because he allowed the mystery of godliness to dwell in his body.
Amen.
He allowed his life to be tuned by the goals of the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Not by what is seen, not by material things, but by eternal things. Unknowingly we get trapped. I sometimes call the bliss trap, where you get too many blessings and you get trapped in that. A promotion can sometimes be equally dangerous, that you get too busy that you forget about God. Hallelujah. God has conquered death. God has given us eternal life. Why? There are so many around us who are dying.
Amen.
I am sure there are many perishing in your socks. I will go back after 1 week, but you are going to be here. Once you receive power from above, you can't remain silent.
Hallelujah.
You are going to share God's word to somebody a day, every day. And you are going to bring in one person to church every week. And as you bring that person, you are getting treasures in the kingdom of God.
Amen.
We are going to work like a team. Now these are the last days. He posed His fire and spirit on everyone.
Amen.
You know, when army, when the last minute and when they are desperate, they take gun and give it to a 16-year-old and say, you start shooting also. You start, they're giving everybody. So before it was only meant for pastors and evangelists. Now the gun is being to everyone. You take and start shooting. There's no time left. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are going to prepare an army of God here. Who are going to be empowered by the Holy Spirit. Who are not going to remain silent, but going to be filled with the Holy Spirit and life manifest in them and trying to share that life and joy outside.
Amen.
Uncontainable. Irrepressible. Hallelujah. Overflowing. Overflowing. That others will be touched by the contagious love and peace and power and godliness in your life. Hallelujah. We have a great battle. We need to win that battle. And God, this is a special army. I think these are the major generals sitting here. The colonels are all going to come tomorrow. And the sergeants will come day after. And the final day we will have ordinary recruitment. Hallelujah. This is a great army of God.
Amen.
God wants to put His life into you, your life.
Amen.
And the power into your life.
Amen.
When you say everything is over, it is not over. It's just the beginning. He has brought eternal life. And He has promised this from the beginning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm going to come to a very important verse, which I love most in my life. Is John chapter 10, verse 10. Why I said all this is because of that verse. John's Gospel, chapter 10, verse 10. It says, Jesus says, I have come. Yes, anybody? A thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But I have come that you may have life, and life in its fullness, abundantly. So God has come, Jesus has come, that we will have abundant life.
Amen.
Life in its fullness. What is this abundant life? Are we experiencing this abundant life? Or are we tired of life? Are we fed up of life? Do we say this is enough? What are we? Where are we? Are we in the right direction? Are we having this abundant life? This evening, we are going to start thinking. It's a beginning. The platform is being set to have more power and more fire about abundant life. This abundant life is not connected with age. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. I can hear something. And I saw there was more life. More life than an ordinary child. And I wanted to be that one. God saved me. I was hydrocephalic. I will give you more of my testimony. But maybe I'll start with one word. When I was born as the first child of my parents, I was not born as an ordinary child. I was born as a hydrocephalic baby. Hydrocephalus, I don't know how many of you know. Hydro means water. Cephalus means head. A big head full of water inside. Those days there was no surgery. I thank God there was no surgery. Otherwise some neurosurgeon would have put his knife on my head. They went and showed me to my professor, the first neurosurgeon in our country, Dr. Jacob Chandi. He said, this child will not live. He will, even if you make him live, he will be mentally, physically retarded. Take him home. They took out many times fluid from my brain. You know, doctors can depress you.
Yes.
Medicine can oppress you.
Yes.
Get a cap out. Don't listen to your doctors.
Right.
Stop listening to your doctors.
I agree.
Listen to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. They said, this child has no hope. If my father and mother had listened to them, that would have been my end. They said, no. We believe in a God who gives more hope. They knew Psalm 121 well. I don't know any of you know 121. I will lift up my eyes unto the hill. From where? There cometh my
help.
My help cometh from the Lord who created heaven and earth. Is that an ordinary help? It's not from a police station or a collector or a multi-specialty hospital. My help come from a God who created heaven and earth.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Bible doesn't say my help may come, can come, should come. Cometh. What does it mean, cometh? Anytime and every time you need a help, it comes.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You may be alone in your bedroom. You may be alone driving. You may be struggling in your life, but I can tell you there is a place from where the help comes. You are looking here and there for help, but there is a place from where the help comes. And they knew with this child there was no other hope but other than this place. Hallelujah. They lifted their eyes and they prayed. And the help came. You know what was the help? From Matthew. Matthew's gospel, a word spoke to them. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. We don't like to hear that verse. We want the help with a shortcut. Quickly. Then everything shall be added unto you. What did they do? They left this child who was vomiting, not eating, dying with the grandmother. Got into a motorbike. Took this Bible, went around saying, Jesus saves. Jesus is a healer. Child is very sick at home. They say, Jesus is the Savior. And they are not very happy in their mind. They had the faith to go seeking the kingdom of God. And then what happened? The kingdom of God came down for me.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. If the kingdom of God comes into your house, what will happen? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah is right.
You seek the kingdom of God, and the kingdom of God has come down to you.
Yes.
Amen.
Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Everything shall be added unto you.
Amen.
All that you need will be added into your life.
Yes.
Amen.
God decided to heal me. Hallelujah. I am standing here because Jesus healed me.
Amen.
I am a neurosurgeon. I know how to operate. But it is God who heals.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Since of lack of time, I want to go quickly and close up with few more words. Hallelujah. 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 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 9.
God is faithful, by whom ye were called unto the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord.
We are called to the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ the Lord. Why? Not only save us from sin, but to give us abundant life. Not only to give us abundant life, but to make us his children. To give us the inheritance of the kingdom of God. And give us the authority. Some of us don't have the authority. The key to the kingdom of God, he's giving us. And then we become not ordinary people, not extraordinary people, but supernatural people. Hallelujah. People who are led by the power of the Holy Ghost. And then things start happening in your life. First you will see it's happening in your life. I can tell you very simple. I was traveling down with my cousin. You may think it's very like a joke. And I was coming. And I was staying. First day I was staying in a place. And we were watching the TV and there was a lot of watermelon. I said, this we get in plenty in America. It must be expensive here. How can I get a lot of watermelon? So my cousin laughed and said, here also you may get watermelon sometimes. And we go into a Chinese restaurant for a buffet. $7 a buffet. And there is only watermelon, large amount kept. I told my cousin Chitra, see that? I say, and the watermelon comes. God does not make you a child of God, denying you everything that you need. Even if you think of watermelon, it will come to you. But you don't come to God for watermelon. You follow him for who you are. Don't come to Jesus for blessings.
Amen.
Blessings will follow us.
Amen.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. We don't run after goodness and mercy. Goodness and mercy will follow us all the days of our life. This is a life-changing moment.
Amen.
You have been a child of God and a Christian before, but God is going to give you guns and fire through your life to many people in Osaka. Going to transform your life into a spirit-filled life, a dynamic life. And for that, I'm going to read two verses for you, which will help you. 1 John, back again, 1 John, chapter 2, 24. 1 John, chapter 2, verse 24. Hallelujah. People don't think this is a very important time. This is a very important time. If the word remain in you, then Son and the Father are going to remain in you. Can you imagine walking back with Son and the Father remaining in you? Not the way you came. Hallelujah. 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 The word that was in the beginning, which we saw, heard, then we saw, then we handled and touched. Now finally it is going to abide in us.
Amen.
Remain in us. That is an intense relationship.
Amen.
That is an intense relationship.
Amen.
Not just hearing.
Amen.
Not just seeing. Not just handling.
Hallelujah.
But remaining in you. When you touch people, people will start getting healed.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm a neurosurgeon plus pastor. I have a church. And one day, one new believer, Benny, called me up and said, my child is very sick and I'm operating. I said, Benny, you are a child of God. The power of the Holy Ghost remains in you. Put your hand and pray the child will be healed. This pastor has no time to rush immediately. And the Benny put his hand and prayed and the child got healed.
Mm-hmm.
You've not had miracles happening in your life, through your life, is because you have not put your hand on any sick person. Osaka institution will close down if you start praying for patients. Multi-speciality hospital will close down when the Church of God starts functioning properly.
Amen.
Not the pastor, not the evangelist, the church, every one of us. Hallelujah. This family is a new family. When he saw this miracle, he started praying for everybody. One day his goat became sick, prayed for the goat. Goat started becoming all right. Then he said, this is amazing. Goat getting well, child getting well. Then he looked outside and he found two coconuts which were not bearing fruit. He put the hands on the coconut and started praying. It started bearing fruit. You remain in him. You abide in him. And allow the Spirit of God to work through your life. You are not an ordinary being. You may not have a degree. You may not have any particular capacity. He has taken fishermen, ordinary people, to spread the kingdom of God.
Hallelujah.
We are looking for an ordinary person to become a supernatural person by the power of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Tonight, surrender your life completely, saying, Lord, here I am. He is going to use you. Hallelujah. Let me go proceed a little more. John, 1 John 3 verse 8. I will finish with two more verses. 1 John chapter 3 verse 8.
He that committeth sin is of the devil.
Yeah.
For the devil sinneth from the beginning.
Yes.
For this purpose the Son of God has come.
For this purpose the Son of God has come. Why?
That he might destroy the
that he might destroy the
works of the devil.
Of the devil.
Yes. Hallelujah.
And when the Son of God resides in you, you are going to be a destroyer. You are going to destroy the work of the devil.
Amen.
Devil has no power in your life. Sickness has no power in your life. Hallelujah. 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 A man of God, a prophet of God is on fire till the last breath of his life.
Hallelujah.
Because nothing can destroy him. Nothing can put him to the bed.
Hallelujah.
You are a chosen generation, special people, separated for God to destroy the work of the devil.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Can you smell some work happening around, his work around? Can you smell them? If you can't smell them, you have to finish it off. You are a firefighter.
Amen.
I'm sure the devil is working here also, in this county. If you look around, there are more and more you will see. This is a holy place. West Plains in America is a Bible Belt, if I hear and if I see. This is a good place. But even here, I'm sure the devil is working.
Oh, yes.
He doesn't stop.
He doesn't stop. He's not worried about the notice board and billboards and all that they see. He's still working. But you and I are here.
Amen.
To destroy the work of the
praise
devil.
The Lord.
Amen.
It's a combined effort. The church is going to grow. You are going to bring in people. You are going to share the gospel.
Amen.
Sunday morning will be double number if you are going to bring every one extra person. We had a youth camp in our church this year. We have only 16 children. I said, I need 100. I don't know any children. You know your friends. You bring in. 65 people came. Everyone brought somebody else. It's a blessing. Don't miss your blessing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There are so many people perishing around us, within our family, outside our family. The devil is at work, but Jesus has come to destroy the work of the devil. He started destroying it in my life. I want it to be seen in everybody's life. Today I'm going to pray for you, and I'm sure if you have any problem, if you go to a multi-specialty hospital, and if you have heart problem, you have to see cardiologist. Dr. George, A.K. George. And if he sees and he looks at it and he says, no, you have some neuro problem, then you may have to go to a neurosurgeon. And when you go to a neurosurgeon, he sees and he finds out that there is something to do with your bones, then he will say, an orthopedic surgeon. And the orthopedic surgeon says, no, there's some problem with ENT. So by the time you finish your full rotation, money is gone, time is gone. Hospital is benefited, but here one department only. Whether you have ENT problem, cardiac problem, bone problem, I'm not bothered. He heals everything.
Amen.
He's my HOD. my supervisor, my senior, my advisor, I know he has come to heal you, to destroy the work of the devil. And as you and I pray together, God is going to work tonight. You are not going back as you have come. How many of you want to be changed and going back? Receiving the power of the Holy Ghost. Rejuvenated by the word of God. God is going to touch every one of you. Hallelujah. Jesus has come to destroy the work of the devil.
Amen.
Amen, amen, and amen. First John again, chapter 4, verse 9. 1 John chapter 4, verse 9.
In this the love of God was manifested toward us, that God has sent his only begotten Son into the world that we might live through him.
The love of God was manifest in Jesus. The life was manifest in Jesus. The light was Jesus. He conquered death. He destroyed the power of Satan. Now he has chosen us that he may pour his love into our life. It's very difficult to love.
Amen. It is.
It is. Sometimes you just don't like the look of that person. Sometimes you don't like the sound of that person. So irritating. Sometimes you've lived this person with that person for 30 years and now you're bored of it. Sometimes, you know, you wonder how you can love. There's no reason for love. Here is a God who loved us without reason.
Yeah.
Loved us with an eternal love, an everlasting love, the love of God. And when that flows through our life, that is going to transform people.
Amen.
People are not touched by messages, but they are touched by love.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And how are we going to win those souls for Jesus? By the love of God. And I know such lovely people are staying here. Far better than many places in this world. Because I know, otherwise my sister and brother wouldn't stay here too long like this. There's so many people who love them. Now let's take this love into the community. Let's show them that there is a God who loves and cares for them. Let's also show them that we are a people who are here to destroy the work of the devil.
Amen.
Let's also show them that we are not ordinary people, but we are people filled with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let's also show them that there is life manifest in us.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Isn't that wonderful?
Yes.
Isn't that exciting?
Yes.
Isn't that there is going to be a new beginning? A new beginning which you have never seen before? You thought everything is lost. Everything is finished? No! It's just beginning.
Hallelujah.
You can feel it right now. And the things that are holding you back are going to go. I want to take a few minutes of prayer with you. If you need a healing, if you need a blessing, if you need a fresh touch, don't forget these days are days of revival. And many of us will be here to minister till Sunday. Come and receive more and more blessing. Shall we all spend some time in prayer?